Ken Molay here with a tip from the library. Engaging with your audience isn't just a matter of running some polls and asking for a show of hands now and then. There's absolutely nothing wrong with using those features, but you should be thinking about interaction in a much wider sense. You interact with your audience with every statement you make and with every way that you invite them to engage with the material. Watch out for declarative statements that just exist in the abstract, whether or not anybody is there to hear them. You want to find ways to turn those into engagement cues. Here's an example. On January 1st, the law will go into effect and companies will have to show compliance. Well, that's a very factual statement, and it has no engagement power whatsoever. But what if I introduce the same fact in a different way? You've probably heard that the law goes into effect on January 1st. Have you started thinking about what you're going to need to do to show compliance? Now the same information involves thought and action for each individual listener. Did you notice how I phrased it as if I were speaking directly to you rather than to a big indefinite audience? I gave you the responsibility for thinking about what to do. Your brain turns on in active mode instead of sitting passively and letting the facts wash over you. Try to encourage your attendees to type while you're talking. Even before the session begins, start a conversation in the chat area about something innocuous like the weather or whether they've seen the latest blockbuster film. When you do start the session, ask them to type where they're located. Then read back some of those responses and make a comment or two about them. The idea is just to get your attendees comfortable with leaning forward and putting their fingers on the keys. It lets them know that you're paying attention to what they type and that this is a two-way conversation. Find places in your presentation where you can challenge your audience. Instead of just showing them a set of bullet points, ask them if they can guess the information you're about to show them. What do you think was the number one response in our survey? It builds anticipation for the data you're going to reveal and makes attendees an active part of the presentation. If your webinars include demonstrating software or applications or websites, you'll want to click here to see my tips on making those work better. Or you can always head back to the index page to pick another topic. Thanks for watching.